Lisa, I can't eat anymore.
What?
I can't eat anymore.
But there's so much more.
Hi guys, and you're back with iDead of iDead Online, and today we're looking at Food Plus. Yes, there's more where that came from. So we did last time a load of the basics of Food Plus. We're going to carry on letting you know what else is available. So first off is pasta. This restores a hunger of 7 and requires the worktop to be crafted. So to craft this form of pasta, what you're going to need is the spaghetti, which I showed you in the last one, the tomato sauce either side there, which I showed you in the last one as well, the cheese on the top and the bowl on the bottom there, and that'll pop you out one of these pastas. But there's variations available like cheese pasta. Yes, mac and cheese is available. This one also restores a hunger of 7 and requires the worktop. To make the mac and cheese, you're going to need the pasta or spaghetti going straight down through there like that diagonally. You're going to need the upside down bowl shape of cheese like that there, and then the bowl at the bottom there, and that'll pop you out the cheese pasta. So next up is the cooked omelette. Now if you remember beaten eggs from the last one, well this is the advanced version of that. So basically this will restore a hunger of 4 and requires a furnace, as you can see here. You put your beaten eggs into the slot there, put your wood or whatever in the bottom there to heat it up, and that'll pop you out a cooked omelette. Then moving on, we've got cereal. Yes, if you want some breakfast in Minecraft, then cereal's the way to go, and this restores a hunger of 4 as is. Now to make cereal, what you're going to need is some chocolate, because obviously chocolate's part of every healthy breakfast, and some wheat there like that around the edge of it, and that'll pop you out some cereal. But then of course you might want to have a bowl of cereals. I don't know why it's called cereals, but it's a bowl of cereal, yes, and it restores a hunger of 4 and requires the worktop. So to make yourself a bowl of cereal, you're going to need cereal at the top there, your bucket of milk below it, and of course a bowl at the very bottom there. So straight down like that, and that'll pop you out this bowl of cereals. Okay, next up is carrot soup. So if you remember the carrots from last time, well, this is going to restore you a hunger of 7 and a worktop. Now all you need is 3 carrots along the top there, some water bucket there, and a bowl at the bottom there, and that'll pop you out some carrot soup. Yes, surprisingly, it doesn't need to be heated. Now there's an advanced version, that's the broth. Here's the broth there. Doesn't look particularly appetizing, looks more like the swill you'd feed to a pig, but still, nonetheless, this restores a hunger of 6, requires a worktop, and to craft this, you're going to need a raw chicken in the centre, a water bucket above and below that. You're going to need salt diagonally like that in each corner. You're going to need a potato diagonally in the other two corners like that, and that'll pop you out one of these broths. So moving on, we've got muffins. Yes, muffins. Alternatives to cookies, you want a muffin. This will restore a hunger of 1 and requires a worktop. So to make this, what you're going to need is chocolate in the direct centre there, an egg this side of it, a sugar that side of it, a bucket of milk above it, and then 3 wheat at the bottom there like that, and that'll pop you out 5 of these muffins. Now moving on, we've got the donut. Yes, donuts. Who doesn't love a donut? Yes, like Homer Simpson would say, donut. But still, this restores a hunger of 1 as a base item. This is an unflavored donut and requires the worktop to be crafted. Now to get yourself a donut, you're just going to need to make dough and put it all the way around the outside like that. If you remember dough, it was covered in the last tutorial, and that'll pop you out 4 of these donuts. Next up, chocolate donuts. Yes, the best kind of donut, and that's why I'm covering it first. It restores a hunger of 3.5, so that's 3.5 of your little meat popsicle things at the bottom there, your little chicken wings. Well, yeah, to make this, you're going to need the worktop, and you'll need some chocolate and a donut, and you just put the chocolate above, the donut in the middle there, and that'll pop you out a chocolate donut. But there's more advanced versions. If you make some strawberry jam, which restores a hunger of 3 by itself, you can do this. So look, if you've got water bucket at the bottom there, strawberry in the centre there, and then sugar above and to each side of it, and that'll pop you out strawberry jam. Now the strawberry jam can then be used to make a strawberry donut, yes, and this restores a hunger of 4.5 as well. So to make this, all you're going to need is your strawberry jam at the top there, your donut in the middle there, and that'll pop you out one of these strawberry donuts. But there's still more, yes. There's the candy sprinkles. Yes, this will restore no hunger because you cannot eat this candy sprinkles by themselves. But to get them, all you need is a candy flower, which you can find around the map and has the same sort of particle effect as the actual Nevergate. So if you find this and you get yourself a bowl, put it right below it, it'll make you candy sprinkles, which you can then turn into a donut with sprinkles. Yes, this restores a hunger of 2.5 and requires the worktop. So to make one of these, you just need a donut. You need some candy sprinkles at the top there, donut in the middle there, and that'll pop you out the donut with sprinkles. Okay, so moving on, you've got the sugar donut, a little bit easier to make, but only restores a hunger of 2. Does require the worktop like the previous ones. And to make this, you just need a donut in the center there, the sugar on the top there, and that'll pop you out this sugar donut. So moving on, we've got the slime donut. Slightly unusual, I don't know why you'd want to eat a slime covered donut, but still, it's possible. You can get hunger of 3 from this one, and requires the worktop to craft. And yes, you've guessed it, you just need a slime ball at the top there, donut in the middle there, and there you go, you've got your slime donut. But there's even more advanced versions. There's the never donut. Yes, the never donut doesn't only restore 3.5 of your actual hunger, but it also allows you to have a buff, which is a resistance buff, I believe. It only lasts a few seconds, but still, it's a buff, so you can get that. And all you need is the worktop to craft this one. What you're going to need is your basic never rack from the never itself, your donut in the center there, and there you go, you can turn that into a never donut. So it's a good use for never rack. Next is minced meat. Yes, minced meat. Now this is a little bit of a different one. You can't eat it as a standard protein by itself, and you do need it for other things, but we'll show you those in a minute. So this requires the worktop, and to make this, what you're going to need is your raw pork chop in the center. You're going to need some raw meat, which looks awfully like zombie flesh, but it's not, it's the cooked version. And then you need your raw beef either side like that, and a bowl at the bottom, and that'll produce you this minced meat. Now what can you use that for? You can use it for a beef pie. Yes, this restores 1.5 hunger per slice. That's what PS stands for there, per slice, and requires the worktop. This works the same way as the original Minecraft cake. Once you've made your beef pie, you can place it down on the floor and keep right clicking on it, and you'll eat it slice by slice. So to make a beef pie, what you're going to need is 3 lots of wheat at the bottom there, an egg directly in the center. You're going to need salt either side of the egg, and then your minced meat on the top, and that'll pop you out a beef pie. So moving on, we've got fried calamari. Yes, if you've killed any squids in Attack of the Bee Team, you might notice you get these small squids. Well, this is where you can put them into use. It's the fried calamari. It restores a hunger of 2 and requires the, doesn't require the worktop, obviously, I've got that wrong there. It requires you to have a furnace to make this one, and I'll show you that. So there's your raw squid there you'll get, and there's your fried calamari. So you just need to put the raw squid in, heat it up, and yes, you'll get yourself some fried calamari. Moving on, we've got raw bruschetta. Yes, the bruschetta, as you can see it there, it looks kind of one of the old school kebabs on a stick, but there we go. What we're going to do is you need 2 raw chickens like that, diagonally placed from each other, and then you need to stick at the very bottom there, and that'll create you this raw bruschetta. Now you can cook that, yes, and then that will actually restore some hunger. So it restores a hunger of 3.5, and you can cook this in any standard furnace like that. And all you need to do is put your bruschetta in there, put your coal, wood, or whatever in there, and then just cook it through, and it'll make you one of these. So moving on, we've got dough. Yes, I believe I showed you this in the previous one, but I'm going to show it again here just because I want to make sure I've covered it. So this is a hunger of 0, it requires the worktop, and all you need is some flour and a bucket of water below it, and that'll pop you out 4 dough, which we'll need to make the donuts and other bits. But next up is the bagel. Yes, this is what we can use the dough for as well, and restores a hunger of 2. As you can see, it's just a plain bagel there, looks kind of like the donut, but just obviously from a 2D rather than a 3D perspective. And the bagel itself is made by just putting 4 dough in like that, diagonally from each other around the center, and there you go, you get your bagel. But yes, there's variations of the bagel like the donut. You can get a cream cheese bagel. Yes, restores hunger of 4.5 and requires the worktop to be crafted, this cream cheese. So all you need is 3 pieces of cheese across the center there, puts the cream cheese into a bowl at the bottom there, and that'll pop you out this cream cheese like that. So cream cheese bagel, yes, it restores a hunger of 7, so that's a really good improvement on obviously just eating the raw cream cheese or eating the bagel by itself. So to get this, all you're going to need is the cream cheese that you made previously, and obviously the bagel at the bottom there, and that'll make you this cream cheese bagel. But there's other varieties available. Yes, there's the pizza bagel, restoring a hunger of 9, so this is a really good piece of food and requires the worktops you've crafted. It does require some additional ingredients. As you can see here, you need the bagel at the very bottom in the middle, you need a tomato, a steak, and a cheese across the center there, and that'll make you a pizza bagel. Now you can also get waffles. Yes, waffles, because who doesn't want a waffle with their coffee or their dessert? But yes, it restores a hunger of 2 and requires the worktop, and there you can go see what it looks like there. Now to make this, you're just going to need 3 dough like that in the upside down sort of L shape there in the top corner, and that'll produce you 2 waffles. Now what can you use the waffles for? Well, you can make yourself a chocolate waffle. Yes, restores a hunger of 4.5. yes, and requires the worktop like the previous ones, and there you can see there's your waffle covered in chocolate. But yes, to make that, what you're going to need is chocolate in the center of the crafting table there, a waffle directly below it, and out it pops the chocolate waffle. Next up though, there is the cookies. Yes, cookies. Who doesn't love cookies? And this restores a hunger of 0.5. yes, it's a very small amount, but there are improvements upon this. It requires the worktop to be able to be crafted, and all you need is wheat either side like that, and it'll pop you out 8 of these cookies. Now, you can improve upon them by making a chocolate cookie, yes, and restores a hunger of 4, which is a great improvement over 0.5. So, to make one of these, you're going to need a cookie on the top, a cookie on the bottom, and some chocolate in the middle there, so kind of like an Oreo, but with chocolate instead of the cream, and that'll pop you out this chocolate cookie. Moving on, we've got peanut butter, which restores a hunger of 6 by itself. So if you just want to eat peanut butter straight out of the jar, like I know some people do out there, and I know it's you, but no, you can just eat this, and this is going to give you a hunger of, restore a hunger of 6. It requires a worktop. You're going to need to find yourself some peanuts, and you're going to need 5 of them like that there, in the little bowl shape, and then you're going to need some salt in the middle, and that'll pop you out this peanut butter. Now, you can get a peanut butter cookie, yes, peanut butter cookie, and it restores a hunger of 6.5 and requires the worktop to be crafted, and that's what it looks like when you've produced it. To make this, you're just going to need to put your peanut butter in the direct center there of your crafting UI on the worktop and put the cookie directly below it, and out it will pop a peanut butter cookie. Now, moving on, there is Minecraft Cake. Yes, it restores 0.5 per slice. Now, this one's a little bit unusual because you actually will need Silk Touch to get this one, and I'll show you why. You actually need to get a grass block. Now, that's going to be half to do with Silk Touch because you need to mine the standard grass around the landscape, but actually keep it as grass rather than dirt. But yes, if you put dirt all the way around it like that, so you've got 8 pieces of dirt around the center and a grass block in the direct center, it'll pop you out a Minecraft Cake, which works the same way as the standard Minecraft Cakes. So, moving on to pizza dough. Yes, pizza dough, because you can get pizza in this mod as well. Now, you can't eat it raw, and you cannot eat any of the following ones I'm going to show you raw. The hunger stats that I'm going to show you are based on the pizza being cooked in an oven first, okay? But this one requires the worktop. So, what I'm going to do is show you that. All you need is 3 pieces of dough along the bottom there like that, and that'll pop you out a pizza dough. Now, what can you use it for? Well, you can make yourself a tomato pizza. Now, if you cook it, it restores a hunger of 0.5 per slice, and it requires the worktop. Now, I'll show you how to make that. You just need a tomato in the center there. You thought it would be tomato sauce, but no, it's the tomato and the pizza dough at the bottom there. Now, you can improve upon that with a cheese pizza, yes, and this restores a hunger of 0.5 per slice as well and requires the worktop. To make this, you're going to need your raw tomato pizza that you've made previously, so an uncooked version of that, and some cheese on the top there. So cheese in the center, raw tomato pizza below, and that'll put you out this raw cheese pizza. But yes, you can improve upon that with the pork pizza. Yes, this one restores 2 hunger per slice that you eat of it and requires the worktop. Now, to make this, you're just going to need a cooked pork chop and a raw cheese pizza that you've made previously, and that'll pop you out one of these, which is raw pork pizza, but obviously you can cook this, and that's how you get the 2 per slice. But next up, there's zombie pizza. Yes, can you believe it? You can make zombies into pizza, giving you a use for that rotten flesh. And this restores 0.5 hunger per slice, so it's actually a little bit less than the actual pork pizza, but there we go. So this is 0.5 per slice and gives you a use for rotten flesh. You're going to need your rotten flesh there, and you're going to need your raw cheese pizza below it there, and that'll pop you out one of these. Now, when you cook it, you'll get the cooked version of the pizza, and it does require a furnace to cook any one of these pizzas. And as you can see here, that's what it will look like. It'll go from the raw zombie pizza there to a cooked zombie pizza or any of the other previous ones. Now, I wanted to demonstrate to you the actual way you put the world. You can eat this, because if you stand here and right click, it doesn't eat it. Now, it's because it works similarly to the actual Minecraft cake, but only similar to the essence that you need to place it on the ground to get it. And there you go, you can see the zombie pizza there. Now, when you break it, boom, out pop a load of slices, and there you go, you can see I got 8 slices this time. Now, that can actually be quite random. Sometimes I've found I've only got 3 slices, sometimes I get the full 8, so it can be a little bit off when it's actually collecting this, and I don't know why. But yeah, once you've got these pizza slices, you can then right click, and there you go, you can eat the pizza, and that's how you actually use these pizzas. You cannot eat them as a whole, you have to break them down. Alright, so moving on, now we've got some gelatin. Yes, gelatin, it restores a hunger of 0, so you can't eat it as it is, but to make this, what you're going to need is a slime ball, and it'll pop you out free gelatin. So what can we use gelatin for? Well, yes, we can make jelly, and this restores a hunger of 2, yes, and it requires the worktop, and what you're going to need is free gelatin like that across the center of your crafting UI, the bowl below it there, and that'll pop you out some jelly. So moving on, we've got the raw meatball. Yes, this restores a hunger of 6.5. Yes, you can eat it raw, believe it or not, and requires the worktop to craft. All you need to do is put the minced meat that we covered earlier into the crafting UI, and it'll pop you out a raw meatball. But you can go one better. Yes, you can get a cooked meatball, and this covers 7.5 hunger, so it's a little bit better than the 6.5 there by a point. And this one doesn't require a worktop, it requires a furnace to do. So let me just show you here. Look, here's your raw meatball. You put in some wood or whatever there, it'll cook it, and then you'll get your cooked meatball out the other side, and that will allow you to restore 7.5 hunger. So moving on, we've got cans. Yes, this is the last one, and this is moving on to where we're going to start off in the next tutorial. The next one is the can, and this actually restores no hunger. As you can imagine, you can't just eat a can. Or can you? I don't know. But no, you just put iron ingots down either side like that. So 6 iron ingots in total, 3 either side, and that'll pop you out 6 of these cans, so 1 per ingot. And what can you use that for? You can use it for soda, which restores a 0.5 hunger and requires the worker to be crafted. But this is a little bit off-putting because people think, well, 0.5 is not really worth my iron. But actually, this gives you a speed boost because you're going to use sugar in it, so it's like a caffeinated drink. It makes you hyperactive and actually gives you a speed boost. So let's just show you here. This is how you make it. You get your can at the bottom there in the middle. You'll put an ink sack directly above it. But water bucket this side and some sugar that side, and it'll pop you out one of these sodas. And when you drink that, you'll get a speed boost. And I'll just demonstrate that for you here. If I drink this, and there you go, and you throw away your rubbish afterwards, and there you go, speed boost there for 20 seconds it lasts for, and you can move a lot faster. So there we go, that's everything for this one of the Food Plus mod. But before we go, I wanted to say a big thank you to all of the guys who made the tutorial possible, because obviously if you saw that great intro at the start, I know some people, most people won't like it, and I apologise for that, but I thought it was hilarious, and I want to thank the guys who helped me make that, and they are Space Nerd, who helped me out of that, there was Risakin, who helped me out of that as well, Kirito Gaming, Kaneda, I believe it is, Buffoonery Accord, and obviously the voice of Oliver himself was Rewind, and obviously my good buddy Tennessee Gaming actually played the part of Oliver. So those are all the guys who helped me out with making that intro, and you can check out their channels. They're all linked directly below this video, so please do give them a click, give them some love for helping me out with that. And until next time, you make sure that you look after yourselves, guys. Remember to subscribe and like if you enjoyed this video. Until next time, I'll catch you soon.